What's up? Coach Dan Blewett here. So today's video for baseball players, I want to talk about a mindset that you should have that's going to help you understand how you can continue to get better over time and a way to sort of audit yourself and your ability to kind of look for like leaky boards and ways to improve yourself. So one of the ways that I used to conceptualize myself in college was I wondered if there was an alternate universe Dan, and if that alternate universe Dan existed, and he was faster than me, he was bigger than me, he was stronger than me, he was more flexible than me, would that guy be a better baseball player than me? So when you think about all the attributes a ball player has, right, like forearm strength and size, like your upper body strength, your flexibility, your speed, how often you do conditioning, how physically just big and strong you are, how flexible you are, how mobile you are, how good your mechanics are, how strong you are mentally, how good your diet is. When you start thinking of all these different areas of your body as like weak points or strong points, then you can sort of start to go down the list and say, where might I have, you know, if you were a ship and you had like, you know, all the planks on the bottom, like where might be a board that's a little bit leaky, where it's letting a little bit of water into the boat that's kind of like sinking me. And so when you consider who you are today and you compare that person to someone in the future or your doppelganger, which is a German word for double goer, which means just like you in another universe. When you think of like the perfect you versus today's you, how can you compare the two? So what I thought was maybe like every 3 or 6 months, I was like, okay, my legs are really big and strong. I can deadlift 400 pounds now. I'm 190 pounds. You know, that was me as like a sophomore. Do my legs need to be bigger? So I'm 190 pounds, my legs are pretty big and strong. If there's an alternate universe Dan who can deadlift 500 pounds, is he a better pitcher than me? Or alternate universe Dan can deadlift 600 pounds, is he better than me? At some point, you're gonna ask yourself that question when you start to get really well conditioned and you start doing the right things, and you're gonna say no. At some point, like with deadlifting, for example, you're probably not a better baseball player because you deadlift 500 pounds versus 450 pounds. Now, 450 pounds versus 250 pounds, the answer is yes. If today's Dan can only deadlift 250 pounds, he's not really that strong. But if alternate universe Dan can deadlift 500 pounds, that guy is significantly stronger and probably significantly bigger, and he probably throws a mile per hour or two harder than 250 pound weakling Dan, right? So if you take that mindset to your whole body, to everything in your training regimen, so you again talk about your conditioning, your mental training, your forearms, your legs, your core, your strength, all this different stuff, your mobility, your flexibility, you start to tag all these different things and you compare them to some theoretical excellent number. Again, like deadlifting, maybe it's like 450 pounds or 500 pounds. Squatting, maybe it's 300 or 400 pounds. Your sprint time, like if when I was a freshman in college, I could run a 7.860. That's pretty slow. When I was a sophomore, by the end of my sophomore year, I ran a 7.60 because I got a lot faster. Well, I got a lot faster. I got a lot stronger. I was running all the time with my college, obviously. I was eating healthy. Like I was doing all these things. And so I was a lot more explosive. And so I sprinted faster. And when you sprint faster, it's saying, okay, your body can do a lot more things. It produces power. It's explosive. That stuff translates on the mound. It translates if you're a pitcher, it translates if you're a golfer, it translates if you're a basketball player. When you're just more explosive, you can do more things better. So for me, saying, okay, today's Dan runs a 7.860, doppelganger Dan runs a 7.60, which guy throws harder? It's definitely the guy that's faster, right? So let's work on developing explosiveness and power. That's maybe something I should focus on now. And now, when you have a pitcher who can run a 7.60, does he need to run a 6.8 to be a better pitcher? It might have a very, very tiny effect on his ability. We have, again, of course, sort of fill up all these bars. If you imagine yourself as like a video game character, you know, you have flexibility. You could be up to 10, right? You know, you could be at a 6 today, and if your meter goes up, you know, the best players in video games are like 9, 9, 9, 8, 9, 10, 7, right? Like Ken Griffey Jr. back in the day in those old Super Nintendo games was like 999. So he was super fast, super strong. He could crush the ball. He had a great contact swing, great power swing, all that stuff. He could do everything. So this is a good mindset to have, that if you take an inventory of your skills today, your physical skills, your conditioning, your regimen, and you say, if there was a guy, a version of me, my twin in another universe, and he was better at X, would that make him a better ball player? And if the answer is yes, then you need to have a hard conversation with yourself. Like, what can I do to get myself to alternate universe Dan's level, or alternate universe Jake's level, or whatever your name is? So that's a good mindset to have, because it's always going to give you something to refer back to. It's your theoretical best, right? So if one day you can do 20 chin-ups and you're deadlifting 500 pounds and you're squatting 400 pounds and you're on a 7 flat 60 and you can broad jump, you know, like 9 feet. I actually don't know what's good broad jumping anymore. That seems like it's good. But you start to fill up all those buckets and all your physical measurements, and you're eating really healthy, where if you compared yourself to a theoretical, again, alternate universe version of yourself, and you're like, that guy couldn't be much better than me with his diet. That guy couldn't be much better in his flexibility. He couldn't be much better in his mechanics. He couldn't be much better with his arm care routine, right? Where you start leaving like, all right, I'm like doing pretty well for this, again, theoretical standard that I'm holding myself to. So there's lots of different ways you can conceptualize your career and your training and what you want out of your own life, right? And work ethic is huge, and that's really what this is a tool for. But when you're really honest with yourself and you have a good idea of how you can kind of, again, continually quiz yourself and audit yourself. Auditing just means to go through and sort of check all the boxes and figure out what's there and what's not. Then you can go forward and say, all right, I think I need to work on my flexibility, because future or alternate universe Dan is probably a lot more flexible than I am. And I feel like that's an area that I can improve on. I might throw a little harder. My mechanics might be better. It might help me stay healthy longer. All those things. Okay. So I hope this video helped. It's really important as an athlete, not just to have, you know, a great coach who can tell you what to do or a trainer that can tell you what to do, but also you have to be the steward of your own career, the carpenter. You're building your own self. Like, you're a house. You're the one who's ultimately going to lay the foundation. You're the one who's going to put all the boards up and planks up and put the roof up. So make sure you're taking stock in yourself and really considering what you're doing and why. And if you always have a good reason for why you're training, or you find gaps in your training, then you're going to be motivated to say, okay, this is where I want to do a little bit more, because I really want to be a D1 baseball player, or I really want to be a pro baseball player. And I'm going to put in the work, and I'm going to put in smart work, not just more grunt work that maybe isn't leading me in the right direction, because that's the thing we also want to avoid. You don't want to just do more stuff that you're really good at. You want to start to, again, fill up those weaknesses, and that's where comparing yourself to your alternate universe perfect version is really going to help, okay? Hopefully this video helped. I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to the channel, share with a friend, check out all my books and links in the description below, and I'll see you in the next one.